You will permit me to honor my mother in the Lord and my mother-in-law. She's here. This is a woman that God used to give birth to me spiritually. I'm sure she's a parent. The Lord, please, this is your day. Can you stand up? Hallelujah. Praise God. I went to marry and I married a mother in the Lord. She ministered the Holy Spirit to me in her house, in the village. I went for preparation for traditional wedding. I married her, they later on me, and I went, and ever since then, God has kept me. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. What am I saying? I saw in the visions of God that men began to dance. And as they began to dance, and I tell people that this is the year of Jaga Jaga dance. They began to dance, and while dancing, they had things written on the floors, and they had things pasted on walls, and each one of them were woes. Evil things, things that they didn't want. And as they began to dance, I saw another band of angels. They will come and tear off the papers. And I said, Lord, what is this? He said, the Valley of Baraka. One of the names of my companies is called Baraka. I have two companies. One is Kujitek, the other one is called Baraka. And while they began to dance, angels came and joined them. And as the angels came, the angels interpreted their fate in their song and in their dance. And the angels began to roll away the stones. And suddenly, the angels began to instruct them. When you leave this place now, where you go, don't go to the left, go to the right. Angels began to give them instruction and direction. Inspiration suddenly filled men from the place of worship. Suddenly they were dancing, and a word would rise up from within them, and as they prophesied, the Spirit will come from heaven and say, it is God.
Amen.
Why am I saying this? It's not to say it is the Jehoshaphat year.
Amen.
The year of ambushment.
From where?
All right.
If you don't have dance issues, go by one. I tell you, you will be dancing and your infirmity will not drop.
Amen.
It is a year of sound.
Hallelujah.
Let's write down what you want God to do for you this year. And anytime you ask God for something this year, beloved, carry money or gold or silver or something, add to it.
Yes.
Of course, you know I'm part of those who build that altar to build. I know we miss this opportunity. I've been building it everywhere because it's God's command. I'm a dispensational teacher. I can preach one word for 1 year. And finish. If you like, say, but that's me. I can preach all this for 1 year. Anyway, you write me. If you like, write me 10,000 topics. When I will just declare and swear, I will leave the one way you want. I will go the one way God sent me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So please learn to dance. Learn to develop a merry heart this year. It's going to help you a lot.
Amen.
Please, I beg you one more thing. I want to beg you before we take this communion. Please avoid sin this year.
Sin.
Sin. S-I-N. S-I-N. You see, she was talking about the threefold cord. And God showed me a triangle of Satan. And the triangle of Satan was, number one, death. The second was hell. And then the other one was the prince of darkness stood in the midst of the stars. I was reordering the stars. And I said, Lord, what is this? He said, son, that is the will of the enemy this year. And that is why one scripture that you must not forget this year is seeking a host of seven stars in his hands. Is in Amos chapter 5. Seeking the host what? The seven stars in his hands. If you don't learn how to control the constellations this year, I don't know how it will be. But today, the Lord is already seated for you.
Amen.
And things have been rearranged.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
What do I mean? I saw that triangle, and this is how it worked. these human beings to express this. Let me use this. Now, let's call this a tribe. Let's call here now, the head of the tribe. On top of this was a spirit. And what was the spirit doing? The spirit was dwelling in the midst of the stars. I was using the star as a cauldron, as a pot, to control human emotions and to steer human emotions to do sin, to commit sin, to do iniquity, to do that which is contrary to the will of the Lord. And that is why one battle that you must fight is that you will see an attempt of the old man to try to come back to you. Habits you have left behind, suddenly they will come like a rush. Once they come, look, you will reject it, but you will point your finger to the heavens and you will say, in the name of he that holds the seven stars in his hands, I overthrow the astral manipulation that is behind it. My soul shall not answer to you. Why? It is from the stars that they are going to fight the church in this year. And you know what put fear in me? While that spirit was doing that, hell and death were just waiting. Immediately, the man, that arrow that was shot from the stars, took hold of that man, and that man broke the head. You know what happened? Death rushed them off. And immediately, death rushed them off. You know what happened? Hell swallowed them. It means that this year is going to be like this. Today, this man is here. You go tomorrow, they say he's no longer here. Why? Either he is dead or he's disqualified. Sudden things will happen this year. Hello? And now, for those, the righteous, who will not fall victim, the next battle that the enemy will battle them is to rule their emotions, to make them do the right things, but at the wrong time and in the wrong place. I'm telling you the battle of the enemy. How is the enemy? How is the tripartite agreement? How is the triune government of Satan? Who are the three spirits? And what is the intent of the three spirits that Satan has sent to the earth? And that is why you will notice that the year opened with what? Death. They called me, they sent me a text yesterday that a very good friend of mine, a childhood friend of mine, why should the young man die? How old is he? What has he achieved on the earth that is dying? And you know what he died? Folly killed him. Foolishness killed him. Why would a man who is my age, or maybe I'm even a year older than him, what is he doing with a power bike? And he's driving a power bike all the way from Lagos to where? All to Port Harcourt. Is he a madman? I'm not going to go for his burial. For what? He killed himself. Watch your emotions, watch your excesses. Put a check on yourself this year. Be careful where you go so that you don't die the death that the wicked has appointed for you and your name God. Why? The enemy wants to reproach the name of the Lord. Hell has a line amount. And with death and with the prince of the power of the earth sitting in the dwellings of the stars and seeking men to devour them, you will not be a victim.
Amen.
Remember, I said number one, if it is not sin, they will try to manipulate you to do the right thing at the wrong time. You will say, how? The examples in the Bible. Moses, the ancient one himself. Moses did the right thing by trying to bring water, but he did it the wrong way. What happened? Moses didn't finish his destiny. Many men are going to go to heaven this year if they are not careful, but they will not have fulfilled destiny. Be careful! The rush of hell. And it is because of this that you are going to take the communion. It is because of this that you are going to anoint your forehead. Because it's a conspiracy from hell, but God has an answer. Don't be afraid. I'm telling you. And that's why one scripture you will notice in that book of Revelation chapter 1, they said, and the Lord had also what? He was holding seven stars in his hands. And the Bible says those seven stars were the angels of the church. And they walked in the midst of the candlestick, and the candlesticks were who? The body of Christ. Angels are going to be, they're just going to work. And he must begin to ask them to rearrange the stars on your behalf. That the evil planted in the stars shall not take hold of your soul, your spirit, or your body. None of you will die.
Amen.
Be careful. Be careful. And these are the reasons why we're going to take this communion. These are the witnesses God bore to my heart. If it's my father in the Lord, Pastor Kuro kept seeing different dreams and visions. One of the dreams he saw wild animals. The anything that came to their sight, they ate it all. They just kept eating them all, ravaging animals. They were just ravaging the nation. Bam! Bam! And they had teeth. You know, monstrous teeth, they were just snapping things away. And God said, only the watchman can answer that army. And those watchmen are going to be princes. And he gave us a scripture in Isaiah chapter 21. But like I said, I don't want to read the scriptures. I just want to talk to you as a counselor who has come from the watchtower to show you the way. Finally, I want to plead with you. Everything that you want God to do in this 1 year. You notice she kept talking about 10 years, but she kept emphasizing on this 1 year. God told me that this 1 year, and that's why you're going to take that offering of 10,000. Really? This year is a first fruit year. This is the year to put your strength and strengthen your court. Enlarge your tent the way you want it. I saw the Lord declare that if men will follow the way and the vision of heaven, I in 1 year, in 12 calendar months, broken into three quarters, using number four as a division, and then bringing off offerings divided into three, like in the day of Genesis chapter 15, when Abraham made a sacrifice of three, and she kept talking about three. And when you add three to four, it becomes seven. And through the altar number seven, you destroy Balaam and Balak. God told me, tell every man, write down the vision. Make it plain. Let him that seeth it run with it. It's found in Habakkuk. I think it's chapter 3 or chapter 2. Chapter 2, verse 2 and 3, yes, that's right. Verse 2. Now he goes down, he talks about it, and it ends up connected to faith, really. He ends up, he says, though it may tarry, then he says, though it may tarry, but do you know, he ended with what? It will surely come to pass. And I saw that as we wrote down, God said, every man must write down what he wants him to do for him in what? In these 12 calendar months. But look, everything you're writing, you must do it with the eye that look, if these things are established in this 1 year, I can challenge the 10 years.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And through the work of God in 10 years, I can face a generation 50 years, another jubilee.
Amen. Amen.
Hello. So God doesn't say, Lord, give me 5 cars. What will the 5 cars enable you to establish? Like me, I'm asking God to give me within now and April or March to give me the best instruments that I can use with cars that I'm going to use to go around the East, traveling from village to village, just proclaiming the day of the Lord has come upon you, you man of the East. I anoint you, O man. Though you are people that defy your members, you shall not defy yourselves anymore.
Amen.
That's my job. Everything you ask the Lord for when you're writing that list must be something that will enhance what you believe is God's will, your destiny. Not just God does what asks for clothes. Mm-mm. If my clothes will make you become, no problem. I'm not saying the good things of life are not part of it. They are. She's already proclaimed it anyway, so nothing can stop it. Actually, this year, don't mark yourself that you're in right standing with God by prosperity, you'll be deceived.
Yeah.
Because prosperity will be abundant. I'm telling you, for the righteous, but for the church, there will be greenness. But in the midst of the greenness, the enemy will be snapping people away. So if you use those things to measure that God is with you, be careful. Let the Holy Spirit bear witness to your heart that you are one with God. He's a hearer of the Spirit. Now, when you write them down, you must appoint time to them. And the decimal or the divider or the marker is 4 months. Meaning we're going to have, and you're going to have, this year we're going to have 3 seasons. January to April. April to the next. Am I right? The 8th month is August, am I right?
Yes.
Meaning April to August. Then August what? December. You must appoint time. You know why? He rules. God relates with man in time and in season. He says, when you finish that, now you know what he told me? You take an offering. That offering, you break it into 3. And God called it, used a name. He said, is an offering of life. And I said, oh, what do you mean by an offering of life? He said, it's an offering of life, number one, because it's not that one, you just put your hand like this. You know, I can call for offering now, you just put your hand. Or you say, yeah, what do I have in my hand now? It's an offering of life because, number one, it is tangible, but more importantly, because it is hallowed. How the way is an example of a hallowed offering. The one that Abraham made. When he finished making the sacrifice, Abraham didn't go. He took a chair and he sacrificed. Reverend men will come, he will chase them away. And while he was yet watching over the offering, the Bible says a furnace of fire came. And once the furnace of fire accepted the offering, a covenant was made. And God said that the offerings which you bring, by which you bind those things that you are bringing unto him, immediately you hand it over to the Lord says, it shall no longer be an expectation and a request. It will become a thus says the Lord.
Amen.
A promise that cannot be broken.
Amen.
Because it is sealed by a covenant.
Amen.
Meaning that those things you call offerings eventually become what? Seeds of covenant. And whenever you talk about a covenant, covenants are attended to by spirits. It means that God will then assign angels specifically, and they will take that which you have written. The things you write are going to become part of the scrolls and assignment of the head angels of 2011. It will be their responsibility. They will begin to interfere with time and season. They will create circumstances to bring it to pass. They will remove any stumbling block that will stand in the way. Not only will they do that, they will begin to teach you and show you what to do to bring them to pass.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The switch. What you wrote was ordinary. You thought it was ordinary. You just gave an ordinary gift. And he decided to visit you like you said, Cornelius. Praise God. That you might not be able to do here. Are you hearing me? Because when you finish writing those things, you will dance over those offerings. You might even pray over that those offerings together with those things for at least as you're led over until the day that you know that something has broken loose in the spirit. Then you will gather the offerings. And please, this is I'm telling you to write. It's not the one you write, it's the paper. Buy a book. Because as long as the Lord liveth, each one of them will come to pass.
Amen.
So, what you hallow will hallow you. Buy that book and watch. At the end of each quarter, and please note, those 3 offerings that you've broken into 3, you will give them all at once. But at the end of each season, you will compare notes. And then you take another offering to renew things. Now at that time, it doesn't need to be as tangible as the others. But if God has done so much for you, you can decide to double what you give.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If I were you, she didn't, well, you people know her, and I did not know you, and I know what's coming here. She didn't send me to raise money for her. But since God allowed me to break the vision here, if I were you, I will sow it to this ministry. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because God allowed the revelation to be broken here. We're going to stop here and we're going to begin to pray. The heavens are already open over us. God has already begun a new thing. You're not the same person that walked into this place. You're living here a new person.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'll leave all the other things to another time. But I know that God's will has been done today.
Amen.
So we're going to rise up and let's begin to pray. The first prayer I'm going to pray, you will tell me the amount, so nobody knows the one you have agreed to do. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know whether it's a million, you know whether it is 100,000, you know whether it is 10,000 that you want to use to build the altar that is carrying the glory of the ransom of these whole 10 days. Praise God. Please note, this is not the offering you brought for the one you brought now. I'm talking about this is a covenant offering we're using to build an altar now. Just trying to make it clear. It's not the regular offering. So if you brought a regular offering, still give your regular offering. I just told her, she came and said, just leave me alone. Hallelujah. Because of the corporate nature of this place, if it was in my own throne room, I would tell them, oh yeah, you will go bring 1 million, come out like this. But God has not allowed me to do that. Actually, not because it's not throne room, because everywhere belongs to my Father. That's the simple truth. He does obey what the way he showed it to me. And I would plead with you to try to redeem, because I know you didn't come prepared, many of you. I'm just taking you otherwise. Try to redeem this within the next 14 days. Possibly better. 1 week. Praise God. So this is not what I'm telling you to say you're giving by faith. That you know that. Are you hearing me? That when the Lord does this, I will give God 1 million. You already have the 1 million somewhere. Are you hearing me? So I'm not telling you to begin to speculate about what you're going to give. And please note, if you cannot give, don't feel condemned. You know why? We're just raising an altar. What we do will affect the entire body of Christ in Abuja and in Nigeria.
Amen.
Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
So please don't feel guilty at all. You have no reason to feel that way. It's just an altar we're raising. Is that very clear?
Yes.
So don't feel condemned. I plead with you. I want to remain. You know, Satan has a love locking you out of what ought to be a blessing when he sits in your flesh. I hope I've made it clear.
Yes.
Praise God. Now, those who want to be part of it, just lift up your hands. There's no need to come out. You know what you told God you will do. Of course, my hands are up also. Praise God. Then, Father, let the angels count them. Let the earth write them. That these words that together we have agreed to raise an altar that carries the language of redemption and ransom. The Lord redeems us from the evil of the past and establishes a new foundation and brings the glory of the blessings of the future and the now, and will cause your spirit that restores to go to the past and restore unto us opportunities that we lost. And Lord, to bring judgment, Lord, upon Haman and his 10 children. And Lord, by this you will number us and you will revive us. For in that day, our Lord and our God, with 10 camels laden with all kind of provisions, a quarrel was settled in the book of Genesis. By this, let there be a settlement of every quarrel in our life.
Amen.
Lord, and in the book of Numbers, Lord, the Bible says that, Lord, they brought spoons of gold. Spoons full of gold. And they brought it to the temple as part of the instrument of the temple. Lord, today accept this in that same revelation.
Amen.
That this year, by this, you will turn us to princes.
Amen.
And by this, Lord, you will redeem us from evil.
Amen.
And Lord, today, Lord, we are in the federal capital territory. That this which we do, Lord, will redeem Nigeria.
Amen.
It will speak in the north, in the east, in the west, and in the south.
Amen.
It will ransom Nigeria, Lord, from the rod of wickedness that is speaking as violence. That today that rod is broken.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Father.
Thank you, Lord.
We give you glory and we give you honor.
Hallelujah.
Therefore, Lord, let the signs and the wonders begin.
Amen.
Thank you, Ancient of Days.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Put down your hands. Now, please, I just want only seven people who will just decide to give 7,000 naira. I want to build I want to raise an altar that will open the wells of Jubilee to us. Praise God. Come if you want to come.
There are seven people already.
Why are you pulling it back?
She wants more than 7,000.
Hallelujah. No. If you want to, you can come, but all I know is that eventually I'm going to buy them in sevens, really. You understand? Hallelujah. He's not coming. No. Yes, I know if you want to come, you can come. All I know is that before we pray, we are going to form groups, bands of sevens. Number seven, please, this year, number seven is going to open the doors of the grave. Anything, listen, 7 days fast, gather seven men, who you can trust with, who you can agree with over a thing. 7 minutes of prayer, 7 minutes of worship every day. Number seven is going to be the key that will unlock that which seems impossible.
Amen. Amen.
That's what God told me. Praise God. So how many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It'll be like some compact must come.
You see, when God has spoken.
I just want one more person, since to complete it so we can have two bands of seven. It is well. Hallelujah. Oh, you're here, here too. Okay, be coming.
Those who want to watch.
Spirit, just be coming. So let's form 3 sevens.
21,
yes. Three full cup. Praise God. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. I need just two more people. 20. Yes. 21. So we're complete.
3, 4, 5.
Now, can you just hold your hands in sevens in cycles? Yeah, seven will be. No, seven first. What? How many? No, wait. 1, 2. It stops with that. Okay. Hold your hands like this. Okay. Come closer. Please come. You put your hands here and put your hand here. The two hands. Very good. Thank God you have already formed this. Okay, seven. Go ahead and arrange it up. Lord, I wear your and your name and your expression.
Yes.
Today I speak like an ancient. And this is the way your spirit has borne witness to us. You spoke about threefold cords. That the enemy is going to rush against us in the ministry of number three. Jesus. Please, you will allow me. Can I have another seven? They will just, that seven will stand alone. They will join with them. Before tasting. We're going to transit to the fourth instant. Once there are seven, they will stop. Are you one of seven? There are more than seven. There are seven. So, Ross, you will do it for your chair. Praise God. No, it's okay. I'm even happy it's all women. No, women bet the new all the time. God is a mystery. Praise God. Father, not by power nor by might, but by your spirit. Today, by this joining of hands, in the covenant of number seven, sealed as threefold cords, and by the joining of hands of another seven, we declare and we announce that we have gone beyond the first day. We have gone beyond the second day. Yes. We are in the third day and we refuse to settle in the third day. Yes. And today we bet the fourth day.
Yes.
The day wherein from the place of your dwelling and the hidden secrets. That which is hidden that is that must be revealed according to appointed times and seasons. To the intent and to the purpose that by that we will show forth your manifold wisdom. Destroy the wisdom of darkness.
Yes.
Lord, have we formed this mind? That according to this law today, let the angels that defend the oath of Jubilee, let them sound the sounds of liberty.
Yes.
For everyone that is here, their family, the works of their hands, their children. And let us reap in our nation, Nigeria.
Yes.
The glory you have appointed by Jubilee.
Yes.
Therefore, today I will build you an altar of number 10 and an altar of number 7. He said, if a man is a pastor, in the third generation, he will be set free.
That's right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
And in the day of the sound of the seventh angel, the mystery of God will have finished. Father, I cannot even explain all of these things. But today, Lord, accept us and accept these words. Let this which we do, Lord, bring down heaven on the earth.
Amen.
And let your will be done.
Amen.
As it is in heaven,
amen,
so will it be from today on the earth.
Amen.
By this, Lord, we build an altar that seals everything you have done today.
Amen.
And the Lord, as we take the blood of the covenant, let it be the blood that seals all this and opens the spiritual and the physical to become one. To bet your divine will in Nigeria and in our lives.
Amen.
And in the nations of the earth.
Amen.
In the name of God the Father,
amen,
God the Son,
amen,
and God the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
It is done in Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
Amen.
Who will do no more except to say, having done this, I proclaim that we have transited.
Amen.
To the fourth estate.
Amen.
Therefore, let wisdom, prudence, understanding,
by which boundaries
can be moved and reordered,
yes,
together with and power be our portion.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
This today is the blood of the covenant of your will that has been declared. For today, Lord, as we take this covenant, let us think he was in that day when the alabaster oil was broken at your feet. Today, break oil on the feet of everyone that shall drink of this communion. For in that day, Jesus was prepared to fulfill destiny. Today, as you take up this communion, I prepare you to walk in this new walk. And I say you will not fall. Hey, I declare your head will never lack ointment.
Amen.
My Father, by this communion, in the covenant of ransom, I, as a priest, like it was in that day that Aaron took a sacrifice and an incense and stood between the living and the dead and commanded the plague to cease, I stand in that revelation and I prophesy today that you, the Lamb of God, you that we eat and drink of today, you will stand between us and our ancestry.
Amen.
You will stand between us and the dust that has cleaved in our feet.
Amen.
And it will sever from our feet every dust of accusation. And a new people will be born this day.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
This is the blood of the covenant that allows